Hey guys, Glenn and Brittany here with Engel & Volkers. We're real estate advisors in Vancouver, and we've got a market update for you. So this is for June 2022. Lately, Brittany and I have been talking about the market more so in discussing, you know, some recent sales. So I'll just kick things off with a few transactions that we did in June. A one-bedroom condo at 1199 Seymour Street. We listed that one, and that one sold very quickly for $1,000 over the asking price. So somebody saw it right away, made an offer, and our clients took the deal because it was a fair price and it made sense. And buyer deal we did at 1199 Marina Side. So phenomenal location. We picked up that one. Again, it was a one bedroom, a little bit of a larger one bedroom, but our client picked that one up for $25,000 less than what the unit above sold for 10 months ago. So that was kind of interesting as well. You know, the property had been on the market for a little while. They actually had offers over $1 million, but those buyers weren't able to bring them to the closing or remove subjects on it for whatever reason. So we found that one pretty interesting. And then we sold a townhouse in North Burnaby. And that was in the 1.1 range, and we sold that in multiple offers for $11,000 over the asking. Just two offers on that one. So there's definitely some interesting things going on out there, and that's, you know, even more so why we want to get on here and have a discussion about the market, because each area, and we always say this, but each area, property type, and price point are behaving very differently. So, Brittany. What are you seeing out there?
Oh my goodness. Well, we've had some good success, but we've also had a couple frustrating ones as well too. The market has changed. So, you know, less buyer demand, but yet less inventory as well too. So what we found is that we had a buyer write an offer on a property that had no other offers at the time. And we wrote a little bit above asking because the expectation of the seller was to get multiple offers. So we wanted to seal the deal fast because the price made sense. We ended up getting a counter offer from that seller for $80,000 over the asking price. So what we're finding right now is that with sellers' expectations and our jobs as realtors is that we have to set them up for success. And multiple offers, when we are setting our clients up for success, multiple offers sometimes make sense if the market temperature is right. We have enough buyer demand in that price point. In this case, the buyer demand was not there. The expectations were high, and we have an unhappy seller and now an unhappy buyer. So we didn't come together on the price. If they would have started at the price of what the market value was, just as Glenn had said before, is that his client was happy with the price of what he took the price at $800,000 because it made sense. If this person would have done the same thing, then my client likely at that point would have likely have done a deal, but because it set the tone wrong, a deal didn't come together. So So right now is that expectations are the biggest thing in this marketplace, and having some open and frank conversations about what the seller should expect. Another one we had an accepted offer on another one of our properties as well. We were told financing was all in good, and then we come to the day before subject removal and the financing isn't all in good. So another thing is we need to be asking the right questions to the buyer's agents. Who are they pre-approved by? You know, all those questions that we used to ask before, and we kind of didn't as much because everyone was happy and go lucky and everything was good with people's financing and people just wanted a property really badly. Yeah. So the temperature has changed.
Yeah. So, I mean, obviously we get this question a lot, apart from, you know, generally how's the market, but especially right now, clients are asking me, you know, our price is coming down. What have you seen? And that sort of sense. So that's kind of why I wanted to sort of just talk about those listings where, you know, I think about the $800,000 condo and I think like, that's great value. And, you know, stats from the real estate board are showing the benchmark price for all property types is up compared to this time last year. So I'm kind of seeing prices maybe leveling a little bit. Of course, then the Marina Side one, that you could say prices came down because that was a 10, you know, less than what it sold for 10 months ago. So I'm kind of, you know, then I think about again, the $800,000 one, I think, yeah, a few months ago, we probably would have listed at the same 799, but probably would have gotten like 4, 5, or 6, and maybe it went for 840 or something like that. But the values are still really good. So yeah. what are you saying to your clients about that? Or what have you come across with some of your listings or buyer deals in that sense?
Well, I think buyers right now are kind of coming in with offers of going what they perceive the market is going to go to. And I guess if any of us had that crystal ball, that we would all be not having this conversation right now. So that is what definitely is going, okay, they're coming with their reasoning. Instead of hard facts and numbers, even when we're looking at market comparables, we usually go back 1 to 2 months. And I still think that's valid. I don't think it's valid looking at comparables in February and March, but I think it's very valid looking at May and June, because the market did hit that transition stage in that time. So if we have good hard facts and things are still selling, that is what the market is right now. To take offer prices, you know, you always hear this thing of going, don't chase the market down. Well, if you were incredibly overlisted and you weren't going to get that value in February anyways, then yeah, that would come into, you know, don't chase the market down because you're already having to reduce a significant amount. But if you're priced at market value, you know, in my opinion, that's good, fair value. It's what the market is right now.
Yeah. And I'm always a believer, you know, the closer you are, I mean, we set a listing price and asking price, and that's the marketing price to get people in. It might not necessarily be the sale price, but I'm finding that in most markets, I mean, you have a better chance of getting a full price offer if you priced well. So I think there are some sellers out there, and again, this will be more price point dependent, that aren't getting the action that they thought or that they need, certainly not the offers that they need. And of course, you know, if you can't change any objections about the property or the house, then sometimes the only thing left to change is the price. Mm-hmm. But at the same time right now, because demand has lessened, and sales are down, and so are listings, but more so the demand. So the sales are just more down than the listings are down. You know, I think if a seller can justify their marketing price, then they don't need to necessarily reduce, unless they're running out of time. And then of course you got to do what you have to do. But yeah, right now for some properties and listings, I wouldn't just jump to the price and drop it. I mean, of course, everybody's situations can be a little bit different. So along those lines, you know, another question that we get all the time is, Britt, is now a good time? Like, should I be doing this? Whether buyer or seller, right? And I don't know if I want to say it's a canned answer, but of course, like, you know, anytime's a good time to buy real estate because it's a long-term investment. So the cliche is buy real estate and wait, don't wait to buy real estate. And there's a lot of truth to that. There's a lot of truth to cliches, right? But, you know, in recent history, last year and a half, the market was frantic and buyers were doing everything they could to get into a property. And now we've seen them pull back. And that's typically with some uncertainty in the market and inflation, cost of living, and a rise in mortgage rates. So of course, when buyers are uncertain, they tend to pull back and sellers tend to jump in. Sellers jumping in isn't necessarily the case based on the numbers, but certainly buyers kind of pulling back. So I don't know, maybe the market's just run out of buyers. Maybe people are waiting to see if prices come down more, but then they risk the rising interest rate. So where are the opportunities, Britt? Who? Not where, but let's just say who.
Yeah, well, I think there's a lot of things pressing on everybody's minds these days. Where Vancouver generally doesn't follow what's happening in the economy, to be perfectly frank. We tend to keep above water usually when those things do happen, what's happening around the world. We do have this talk of recession and these looming economics that is happening in this world. So it's weighing heavy on people's minds, right? So I think the one thing is that we're all in a rush to buy real estate when everybody else does, but you also have to pick and choose your times of when it's going to be the best for you, your family, your situation. And I think nothing in the world is going to be able to tell you those factors, because on the flip side, if you're thinking that it's better to rent, well, a lot of people are thinking those things too, and rents have risen dramatically.
So yeah, possibly even find
it's,
one.
It's actually multiple offers in finding a property right now to rent.
So then it's safe to say it might be a good time for an investor to maybe pick up a rental.
Yes. So investors, definitely. I was just about to mention the investor side of things really big time. We have a property right now, which we're going to flip sort of our mode of marketing down to more of the investor side and have a rent roll sheet, just because I feel like more investors are going to get into the marketplace. Obviously, some people are not having as much cash on hand because of what's happening in the stock market and so forth, but people are sometimes looking for a more tangible asset rather than the stock market. And sometimes that's what we see what happens when other markets are taking a real big hit. So remember, in the way that I look at it, is there an opportunity? I think there always is an opportunity. Make sure that you look at things like you said, when you're buying a property, the stuff that you can't change is the stuff that is going to have a negative effect on the value of the property. So when you're buying a property right now, always think about the resale value, even if it's in 5 or 10 years. Always think about those things, because that's what's going to protect you for later on. And just do your research. Just, you know, the emotional side can sort of take over a little bit more, but let's think about everything else that's in the package. So those are the biggest things I'm telling my buyers right now. But I think investor wise, I think there's going to be some real opportunity. And I think that's why downtown is ticking a lot more than other areas right now, because downtown has sort of stayed a level playing field for the last few years because of the pandemic.
Yeah. And it seems like, people, I don't know, I've heard people call the market slow, right? But I think that's just because when you're going up 200 miles an hour and you back off to 150, you're like, yeah, this is pretty slow. Not saying that it was 200, we're at 150, but things are still happening, right? Yeah. And you know, sales, the real estate board stats, 20% below the 10-year average or something of that nature. So yeah, things have quieted a bit. But the climate for making a move right now is so much less stressful, because it just doesn't happen as fast, right? I mean, still, if you're a seller and then a buyer, I mean, still put your property on the market, see what you're going to get for it, the most you can for it, get a longer closing and that sort of thing. But generally speaking, you know, like sellers, you're not in competition with that many other sellers, and same goes for buyers. So, you know, I mean, I don't know. I just hope that nobody's holding off to see how far prices will go down. And again, that depends on their situation, but they, you know, if they're just sitting on a down payment or some money that's not invested, waiting to see what happens here. I think that's a mistake. And, you know, like you said, 5 to 10 years, like long-term, right? That's what real estate is. So, you know, do it when the time's right for you, which is for most people when they have the money. Whether it be the down payment or the qualification. I think the market is very good to be buying or selling.
Oh, definitely. You have to look at your percentages right now of going, okay, well, look at it. Look for, let's just use an example as a family in an apartment right now, and they're selling a 2-bedroom apartment. And say in the hottest of hot markets, they could have gotten 1.1 million, okay? But right now they're selling at just over $1 million. Temperature isn't as hot for this type of property. It's more cookie cutter. So there's a lot more properties like it. Okay. So just say we're riding on $1 million of what they can afford. Well, now they're wanting to upsize. Okay. When the market was at its craziness, when people were just bidding prices up to what values they probably never should have been at the first place, then they're going, okay, well, it's going to be $2 million and it's going to maybe be bid up to $2.2 million. And now they're sitting at maybe being able to buy it for 1.9. Say they get a little bit more of a deal. Look at how much money because they upsized, now you're sitting on $200,000 that you wouldn't have before. So sometimes you got to look at the percentages of where you're buying and where you're selling. And if it makes sense, every situation is going to be so different, but sometimes you've got to break it down a little bit more rather than just think it's going, okay, I need to sell at the peak of the peak, but now I'm going to buy at the peak of the peak. So most likely when you're buying and selling at the peak to peak, you're likely going to spend more money.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, no, for sure. Okay. Anything else you want to add about that? I mean, I know, like, just before when you and I were just chatting, you know, like, people do talk in terms of buyer's market and seller's market. So, you know, I know you'd mentioned based on the numbers, single family seems to be in that balanced realm.
Yeah.
Where condos and apartments, they're still favoring the sellers, but not nearly as much as before.
Not nearly as aggressive as it was before. We were seeing over a 40% sales ratio. And just to break it down, if you don't know what it is that, you know, a balanced market is between that 10 and that 20% sales ratio, and anything over 20% is the seller's market, right? So if you're in a high seller's market when it's a 40% sales ratio. So we're looking at balanced markets for detached houses under $3 million. But what I felt was very interesting is that, you know, it wasn't as much of a buyer's market when you got up to that $4 million price range, which makes me think that people's level of affordability is going up a little bit, because we're seeing that if we talked about this $4 million price range a couple of years ago, we would have seen really low sales ratio for it. So, these, you know, there's all the little micro markets within the market, right? So apartments and townhouses are still very much a seller's market, depending on what the price range is and the price per square foot. But definitely detached houses have definitely softened, which is a positive thing. I think they were going a little bit too much. So,
yeah. Okay. I think that's all I really have. I mean, we could go on and on, but
lots going on. There's so much going on within, and it's changing every week. And remember, guys, it's summertime. We haven't really had some decent summers, even though I've heard of this third wave happening, whatever it may be, but I think people are going to be taken off in August. So just be patient for all the sellers out there. Just be patient. Know that that, you know, you're going to get your showings, and it just takes one offer, just one person.
Yeah. And for buyers, you know, if you're sticking around town, you know, keep looking, because a lot of people, especially July and August, are going to be away. So you're going to have even less competition than before, and you're going to have real sellers that are ready to do a deal. So stay, if you're in the market, stay active. As always, guys, if you made it this far, thank you very much. And if anybody wants more specific information, because I feel like a broken record saying this, but I'll keep saying it, that the market performs differently depending on the neighborhood and the property type and the price point. So it's important to find out exactly what's going on as it pertains to you. Even if you're just curious, even if you're not in the market right now, but you're just like, hey, it's been a couple of years, I wonder where things stand with the value of your property, things of that nature, just reach out to us. We're here to help, and there's no obligation, and we've got time to help anybody that's interested.
Of course. Thanks, everyone.
Okay. Cheers, Brett.
Bye.